As schools across the country find themselves in the middle of a battle over indoctrination versus education, Florida's lawmakers are proposing a new law to defend free speech on college campuses and push back against political bias, even allowing students to record their professors' lectures to capture evidence of bias. Here with more is the author of that bill, Florida State Representative Spencer Roach. Good morning to you.
Good morning, Ainsley, from the great state of Florida. How are you?
It is a great state. So many New Yorkers are moving down there. I don't know if you like that or not. I'm doing well. Thank you so much. Okay, why did you write this bill?
So, listen, I looked at a national survey that was published in 2017, which found that 70% of college students surveyed felt that their university was committed to diversity when that question was asked about race, gender, or religious affiliation. But when that question were asked about political affiliation or diversity of viewpoint, that number dropped from 70 to 50%. And so when you place a premium on people that look differently but think the same, that's not diversity, that's conformity. What we're trying to do here in Florida is ask our students and gauge, is that a problem on Florida campuses?
So I know Florida is a two-party consent law state. So if you record someone, you're not allowed to publish it or actually even do that unless you have permission of the second party, correct?
That's correct. Florida's one of 38 states. It does follow the federal one-party consent regime, but this bill would make it expressly clear that students have the right to record classroom lectures in the classroom only for educational use or in connection with a complaint, and it also prohibits students from republishing that lecture without the lecturer's permission.
So it would just essentially be a student who disagrees with a professor or thinks that they're saying something that's controversial or biased, and then they can present that to the leaders of the college campus?
Well, that's right. It could be used to help keep them honest. It could be used for educational purposes. And, you know, we have gotten some pushback from university professors on this provision, but I would just say this about that. You know, these are public employees. These are state employees. And in really every public employee in the state of Florida, from state attorneys in the courtroom to lawmakers in the state house to police officers with body cams, you know, are recorded and really don't have a proprietary interest in their work product. And I don't know why university professors should be exempt from that.
What do you think this will pass? What's the reaction?
Yes, it's passed both the Florida House and the Florida Senate. It's headed to the governor's desk. I do expect the governor to sign it. And look, when you look at what happened last month with the hacked up 60 Minutes interview, no one knows more about cancel culture than Governor Ron DeSantis, mm-hmm. and I expect him to sign the bill.
You know, I was impressed. I watched a video. University of Chicago presented this video saying that we started seeing all these speakers around the country being canceled, and they said this will not happen here. The university, they said, will not stop speech because some collected people think that speech is wrong or offensive. They said education is to make you think, not to make you feel comfortable. Do you agree with that?
Yes, I do agree with that. In fact, we have a provision in the bill which prevents shielding. It prevents universities from limiting students' access to speakers like a Ben Shapiro, like a Candace Owens, mm-hmm. Based on the content of their thoughts. So look, we want students to be exposed to ideas that are controversial and that they may find deeply offensive. And we need to teach them how to critically evaluate those ideas, debate them, and think for themselves about the validity of these ideas. We don't need to protect them or coddle them.
That's right. Not to think one way. Show both sides and let the students make up their own minds. They're smart enough to do that. Spencer Roach, thanks for what you're doing.